And now we're gonna have more viable for you, because I actually want to see that player play some more. I want to see them get used to online. Actually land a full combo. I'm kind of curious. I should have tried. I mean, it's not like, not like I have anything to fucking lose. I should have just tried to launch the end of that She-Hulk bit, because I wasn't really sure if that was like her off-the-wall normal of like very similar animation. Where it has a hitbox the entire way down versus, you know, like, it ends halfway through the jump and I could have bopped her out of it. Because obviously you recovered pretty much instantly upon hitting the ground and I didn't, but wasn't able to punish it then. Ooh, aw. Aw, you went too far, homie. Surprised that wasn't too high. That looked like it was probably too high to confirm. I'm enjoying this. I like some C-Viper. There's another aw, you fucked up. But yeah, C-Viper's definitely another character on the list that I wish I had a fun little bit of trivia for you if you never heard me say it. Well, I know I say it kinda, sorta, somewhat often. Not terribly often, though. Yo, that instant overhead, though? Viper was one of the original characters I intended to use. Wesker, Viper, Amaterasu. That was the list. That was who I was going to use. And not every single one of those characters. Wesker was not too hard to use. Wesker I just kind of stopped using. I don't know why. But Viper and Amaterasu were beyond my abilities at that point in time. And so then I tried Koopa. Oh, Koopa's another player that is gone, I think. Love that dude. He suggested I play Zero. So I tried out Zero. And I'd already started doing some work with Wolverine at that point in time. So the shell of Wolf, the wonderful, beautiful, amazing, perfect shell, not at all flawed, of Wolverine Zero was born. And that's actually who I used throughout the majority of Vanilla Marvel, where if I was actually any good at the game, or at least any good with the theory of the game, I actually was decent. Like, I did not perform terribly at tournaments, I did pretty well. But, it was still a very deeply flawed team. It was basically entirely momentum dependent. Yo, that Jill though? Like, I'm not even paying any kind of attention. All of a sudden, Jill just bodied some bitches. That's a bad idea. I'm surprised the Viper player let that fly. Like, 4 meter? Viper can do. That's actually not gonna work. That's gonna go underneath it. Should have probably just, like, waited and done EX Seismo. I guess it was a good idea. Ignore me. It's going to bait the Viper player into doing something stupid like wasting all their meter. But yeah, and then after that, I used Dante because I wanted to try out Dante. And he actually worked really well for me because all of Dante's assists are very good. I mean, my Dante sucked. There's no way around. They're pure and simple. My Dante was the bootiest of Dantes. It was a day one Dante through and through, and I never got better because I never bothered to learn. I was completely focused on learning Wolverine and Zero. And I just basically ignored Dante was my assist. And I didn't learn anything with him. I didn't learn how to bold cancel. None of his complicated stuff. And so because of that, I was finally just like, okay, why am I still using Dante? Why am I not using Akuma? So finally I switched to Akuma, and that was my team for the majority of Vanilla Marvel was Wolverine, Zero, Akuma. I threw Hulk in there for Zero at some point in time, just for shits and giggles. And it was actually very fun, but I never used it in a real tournament. I only used that in casuals, because Hulk's fun as hell in casuals. But Hulk's only, like, fun for me because, like, you can play so stupid if you really want to. Which, obviously, if you're playing in tournament, you don't want to just play stupid and fuck around. Yeah. It sucks, because the last Vanilla Marvel tournament I went to, I did so terribly, and that was because that was the first tournament that I can think of that I got after getting my job. And for those of you that don't know, I start my job at about anywhere, just depending on the day and depending on what I'm doing and what extra stuff I've been given. I can start anywhere between 2 a.m. to 5 a.m. And obviously I have to wake up even earlier than that in order to actually, you know, get ready, get clean, all that shit. So, you know, tournaments can regularly run past midnight. obviously at that point in time, I'm kind of a little dead. And so it absolutely sucked because they ran Blaze Blue in the early morning. I joined Blaze Blue just for shits and giggles. I ended up getting top 8 at this tournament for no goddamn good reason. That's not to say it was anything impressive to get to. Damn. How was that not a perfect? What happened? Did Viper eat some armor or something? But that Viper just went nuts. I got top 8 at this Blaze Blue tournament. But so, in doing something that, again, not really impressive. There were like 25 players at best. But still, I went through like 4 or 5 matches that basically, you know, some of them kind of lit up the soul a little bit, drained some adrenaline. And so finally, and then between Blaze Blue running and finally Marvel starting, there was about a 4-hour break, right? 4 hours in between where I just have time to just die and be like, welp, I'm tired now. And so because of that, once Marvel finally started, I played my match. I didn't do too well, but I didn't play against anybody. I didn't play against somebody that was particularly good, so I did manage to win, even though I played like absolute trash. And so then Marvel continued, and I'm sitting there, you know, okay, when's my next match? And I continue sitting there, and I continue sitting there, and I continue sitting there. I don't know what the fuck happened in this pool or what happened outside of the tournament. I sat for 2.5 hours between my first match and my second match, and by the time the second match ramp came up, I was just, I had no mental capacity left. My mind was asleep. I was done. I was a zombie, and I had to play, oh god, what was that dude's name? He's a very well-known, not anymore, I think he's done, but at the time he was a very well-known NorCal player, mostly theory crafting. He was very opinionated, and I think that drew a lot of attention to him. But I can't, what was his name? He was the first one to say that he thinks Firebrand is the best character in the game. It started with a C. Son of a bitch, let me Google that. Surely Google will know all about the Marvel tournament scene, right? Northern California Marvel player starts with a C. A link to NorCal Regionals 2015. That's not, this is, yeah, this is not gonna work. Who the fuck is Fred McMurray? That's definitely not it. Okay, so that didn't help me. I know, god damn it. Ugh! Who was his main team? At the very start, the very first time I met him, he was a Viper player. What is happening? Oh, they're AFK. Because every single time I think about this, I cannot believe I forgot to mention Crocel too. Crocel is awesome. But his name starts with a C, and that's what keeps, like, I just keep thinking. Crisis! There we go. Crisis. See, it's the CR. I played him second round. He was always better than me. Pure and simple. He put in more time. He put in more work. His execution was better. Everything just ended up being, you know, the simple fact of the matter is he's a better player than me on a good day. That was not a good day for me, so I got blown the fuck up. And then, so, obviously lost then. And then I immediately had my second match, pretty much, I mean, my loser's bracket match, directly after that. And again, it was the same thing as the first match. I'm playing this dude who's not terribly strong. Obviously, you know, he's the same, in the same scenario as me. He's in the loser's bracket on the third round. Like, that's not, if you're a good player, it's very rare that you end up in that position by the third round. But, that said, I was winning, and I was doing very well, and then I can't remember what exactly it was, but I fucked something up. I dropped a combo, and he did an X-Factor comeback on me, and after that point, like, everything was just checked out. Like, my mind at that point was like, why the fuck did that happen? What the fuck am I doing? What is even happening here? And then I can't even remember the last match, but I got blown up, and that was my Marvel tournament. It was absolutely terrible. I was completely mentally checked out. And that's the last vanilla Marvel tournament I went to. Actually, that was the last Marvel tournament period I went to. Kind of. I did go to one Ultimate Marvel tournament. It was a release day tournament. But that doesn't really count because, you know, it's a release day thing. It was a casual thing. It wasn't like a real official tournament. It was just like, hey, let's gather everybody together and let's just run a tournament for shits and giggles. Why the fuck not? I actually lost to CJ Showstopper there. I shouldn't have. I shouldn't have, but I insisted on using Strider. Who was I using at that time? I know I was using Nova, and Strider was my anchor, but I cannot remember who I was using in the second position. For the life of me, I cannot remember, and I wish I could. Fight it out. Oh, well. Oh, no, that was not the last tournament I went to. But anyway, that is neither here nor there. The rest of it isn't worth talking about. But yeah, I lost to CJ Showstopper because my Strider was complete booty tier, and I just... Once I lost Nova and whoever my second character was, my Strider came in and was like, duh, what buttons do I press? What do I do? How do I use this character? So it didn't go well. It didn't go well at all. So I ended up losing to him, and then I lost to Orion X Elite later on, because I actually did get pretty decently far in that particular tournament. But still, Orion X Elite is another player who is just... His execution is better than mine, he spends more time in the game than me, he's just a better player than me. And I'm perfectly willing to admit when somebody is just completely better than me, when they just outclass me. And Orion X Elite is definitely a player that has always outclassed me. But he's also like, he's the anime game community's Flo. Does some ridiculous, just amazing... absurd kind of fucking training room shenanigans to you that you never think, like, you would see a video of this and be like, ah, that's not tournament viable, nobody would ever use that in tournament, and then he just breaks it out like it's fucking nothing. That dude's a goddamn amazing player, but whether or not it's nerves or what, he just was never really able to do the same thing in casuals that he was always able to do. Just shout outs to randomness that he was ever able to do in tournament. It makes me sad, because he was godlike. The very first tournament that we went to for Marvel, he pulled out... It was the very first time I ever saw a buttergun in the middle of a combo, and the crowd fucking went nuts, because it was just a casual match at that point in time. Again, casuals, pulling out all the bullshit. But he did it on somebody, he used buttergun in the middle of the combo, and it was a very hype combo. And it just came out of fucking nowhere. The crowd went nuts. It was awesome. But yeah, so anyway, I got blown up by him. Who was he? Zero Spencer Doom, I believe, is who he used at that point in time. So, you know, I'm using three characters that I am not, like, terrible. You know what? Was it Zero Spencer? I mean, not Zero Spencer. Was it Nova Spencer I was using? It might have been. I'm not sure. But that is potentially who I was using. It must have been. Because I think I went from Nova Spencer Strider to Nova Spencer Hawkeye. I think. I'm not... Anyway. He blew me the fuck up. And that was the end of my Ultimate Marvel Tournament career. And now it's time to end my online career. Because this dude's going to blow me the fuck up. Who should I use? Should we use Wolverine? Why the fuck not? For the old days. For the old days. This is not gonna end well. This is not going to end well for anybody involved. Least of all me. I'm gonna die. So quickly.
There can be only one winner. Ready?
I picked the wrong assist. I did the wrong move. My Wolverine, everybody! My Akuma, everybody. Oh, nice, smart. It's so smart when Strider's out to just block. Can I get an assist? No, okay. I'll just lose my Spencer. Fuck it. Fuck it. Yo, this dude is popping off with... Never mind. God damn. I'm blocking that, like... quarter of a second too late every time. Nice. Good shit. Nothing I can do about it. Actually, you know what? I probably could have landed in Demon. But that's not gonna cross my mind. Nope. Not a single X Factor was had that day. I pressed it. Yo, look at this dude. This dude was popping off with a Viper. Good shit. His Viper should have been dead. Like, I should not have... I fucked up everything with Wolverine, which is 100% my fault. But what can you expect, man? I don't know how to use this character no more. Shit. But that's fun. I'm perfectly fine with losing to players like that. It's sad that I don't get to continue playing, but it's my own fault. Like, honestly, at this point in time, the only character I have any kind of a chance at winning with is... Spencer, kind of. My Spencer sucked right there. But that was my own fault, because I kept trying. I wanted to hit him with Akuma. But Akuma just didn't... Whether or not, like, I kept pressing the button just a little bit too late, and I kept getting put back into block stun or what, he didn't come out for me. And then you can't block in this game forever. It's not possible. You will... Eventually, you're going to get tagged by something. And this is not a good sign. Oh, there it goes. Wonder why that happened. I don't think I've ever had the character select screen freeze on me like that. Yeah, Nova Spencer Hawkeye is basically who I need to pick if I want to have any kind of a chance at winning at this point in time. That's not to say I can't, like, relearn. Like, I'm not Wolverine's particularly difficult to pick up, but I did not do what I wanted. I did not perform as I wanted to perform with Wolverine. The main aspect of it really is just the simple fact that I have gotten out of practice with calling assists. And so, ooh, damn, man. Why does this keep happening? Why does this keep happening? Wow, that's... everybody's gone. I wonder... Oh, so I just got fucked. Huh. Wonder what that was. I wonder what causes that. Because, like, my internet is fine. It's not... It hasn't gone down. I don't know. Maybe... Oh, I wonder... You know what? I wonder if the host... Because, like, what? Three people just left? So if the host left, that would kill Spectate. That would do it. Also, actually, you know what? Like, all this shit talk, like, it just occurred to me. But, Sorry. Somebody is, trying to spread the word about a petition in the comment section of my recently released video. Yeah. How about you spread that shit somewhere else? What were we talking about before that bullshit happened? Wolverine? Was that what I was talking? Yeah, not calling assists. And so, like, obviously, you know, if you're not calling assists with Wolverine, you're not going to be able to do your instant overhead versus low mix-up. You're not really going to be able to maintain your pressure very well. And obviously, if you input the completely wrong commands and choose the incorrect assists, because actually the entire point of that Spencer call at the very end, that was supposed to be a reset. And, you know, with if I had picked the correct assist, it's a forced restand. And so the entire point of throwing at that crouching light, you throw out the crouching light, it resets them, it kicks them out of the combo, but now they're reset standing, so I can then do stuff. And I was going to do a crouching light kick and then do a berserker slash behind to do a cross-up mix-up. That was what was going on in my head. And I kind of think that was pretty smart and it would have worked. But I picked the wrong assist, and then everything went downhill from there. Gotta keep your head in the game, man. Can't get mind fucked. Yo, like, what are you doing? I'm so confused. Like, he had her stuck in jam session, and he didn't do it. He didn't run a mix-up, he didn't do anything. He just stood there. Oh, hi! Thank you! Ignore the oh god part. I thought you were gonna trash talk my godlike Wolverine. Actually, I should respond to that. Why would I not respond to that? Why am I acting like an asshole? It's better than watching Zero Virgil! I am just going to add...
symbols?
No homo! That's still in vogue, right? The whole no homo thing, kids still say that. YOLO, no homo, all that shit. Do people actually bother saying YOLO no more? Does that die as it deserved to? Everything dies eventually. Isn't dubstep pretty much gone too? All this shit that like... it basically came up right when I kind of stopped caring about, you know, like, what's popular with the kids these days. I'm no longer a kid anymore, so I don't give a shit. I'm just doing what the fuck I want to do and listen to what the fuck I want to listen to. So I have no idea if people bother listening to dubstep or if that's gone as well. How should we talk about Marvel, Grandpa? How about we talk about Virgil getting his ass kicked? Hell yeah, fuck that character. Punch him in the face. Is it? Literally, in this case.
Player two wins. How could I lose? I got a bionic arm.
Seeing Spencer makes me miss Combo Fiend. He's too busy with Capcom now. It's the same old story. Fucking sellout. Wants to actually earn money and shit. How dare he? How dare he want a paycheck? That's the same thing, like, I never understand why people actually consider, like, getting financial security as being this hugely negative thing. Like, for instance, one of the things that I recently saw, well, not recently, it's been ages, but I don't generally pay attention to when people call people sellouts. So the last time in recent memory that I can remember, The Roots being the band for the Jimmy Fallon, for the late show, or the late night show, the late whatever the fuck it's called with Jimmy Fallon. And, you know what it was? It was because they did, they had Carly Rae Jepsen on, and they did it, they did, like, all the band members of The Roots were all using, like, basically toys for instruments, while Carly Rae Jepsen sang whatever the fuck her song is called, Call Me Maybe? That's right. See, look! I know what the kids are up to! Yeah, because that's popular now. Call Me Maybe's only like 3 years old, 4 years old, 5 years old. How old is it? How old am I? What year is it? So it was because of that, and I just, you know, for some dumbass reason, I scrolled down to see what the YouTube comments were, and one of them was like, man, fuck The Roots. They used to be so godlike, they used to represent the hood with their rap. Now they fucking sold out. Fuck The Roots. And it's just like, motherfucker, they made it. They made it. They are living the dream right now. They got a steady paycheck. They got families. They are living the fucking dream. And you gonna tell them they sold out? Fuck you. God, I wish these guys were still completely very barely known, but made music that I and five other people listen to. Fuck them for going above that. You fucking moron. Kind of shit bugs me so much. God, I wish they were still basically failures instead of massive successes. How dare they? No, that day one? That day one! Oh, he fucked everything up. This dude's fucking everything up too, just like me. Welcome to online, motherfucker. You can't do a damn thing you want to do. Thankfully, Spencer in general is piss easy. It's basically only doing that off-the-wall shit where you OTG them and then get the wall bounce and then try to follow that up. That's the only hard shit that Spencer has. Everything else is easy. I say that and then he drops an easy zipline combo. Ooh, was that too late? Nope. Nope! It's never too late. It's Spencer, motherfucker. Everything works.
Player one wins. You didn't actually think you could win, did you?
I'm gonna use Wolverine one more time. I cannot have that be the final, my final showing of Wolverine. I need to get blown up worse. I need to get destroyed again with him. Because we all know that's what's going to happen. I can't hang. These dudes play. Like, this nice lab and M. Rice, these motherfuckers play. I don't. So yay, time to get blown the fuck up again. Who did I pick? Spencer. Let's pick the... That's the correct assist this time. So maybe everything won't fuck up. Oh god, I'm fucked. Who will come out on top? Oh, you can't even block Viper online. How the fuck are you gonna block Magneto, motherfucker? You're not. Oh god damn. I was about 5 seconds late there. Shout out to that combo though. That was supposed to be a super jump grab. That works though! I don't know what the fuck I'm doing. That doesn't work. I don't know what I was thinking. I was mashing there too. I shouldn't have been mashing. That's always a bad habit of mine. Whenever I get hit. Damn, shit. Whenever I get hit, I mash buttons. And so, like, that's just a free reset. What? Nope. Nope. Don't be predictable. Uh-oh. Uh-oh. I done fucked up. Sure, now he's landing everything, god damn it. This is some bullshit! Uh-oh. Ha! I got crossed up! I wasn't expecting to be behind him. I actually don't know what wins. That does. That was like right when I did. I was like, "What the fuck am I thinking?" Unfamiliarity with the game, son. You forget everything. I should have just done a normal. Like I don't know why I didn't just throw out crouching light. That was dumb of me. But that's what happens. That's what happens when you don't play a game anymore. You don't make right decisions. So anyway. Hope you enjoyed that Marvel. I'm definitely outie. I could continue playing it. No. I could continue playing and actually get used to it again. And actually, well, see, the shitty thing is like, let's be honest. This was actually an incredibly rare session of Marvel. Let me just see how many people are still kind of around just in the general lobbies. So I want to see this. That's actually not very many. That was less than when we started, actually. But so anyway... I can still find matches in this game, right? Like, I can't do this in any anime game except for the most current one, but whenever I pop in Marvel, I can find a match, just like that. And that's beautiful. That is a beautiful thing, to be able to just pop in a game and be able to play it, not, oh, you know, people still play the game, but only on Saturday evenings from 5 p.m. to 5:15 p.m. and if you don't find a match in that time, well, you're fucked. That sucks. That's not an active game. And so, like, yesterday I did try that, ironically, around Saturday evening at 5 p.m. I tried Guilty Gear, O'Neill, and... Oh, wait, no, I didn't try. I was going to say, I don't know why. I thought about trying Persona 4 Arena, but it was like, I don't even... I've never been good at that game. Why would I bother looking at Persona 4 Arena? Guilty Gear actually kind of... confirmed my suspicions that the majority of players that play anime games online tend to be East Coast players, which is why I tend to have, like, usually 1 and 2 bar connections more so than anything else. It's not because my internet sucks, although my internet is obviously not great, we've been through that, blah blah blah, but it's because the majority of people that play anime games online are East Coast players. There were double the people in the East Coast lobby. Actually, there were more than double. There were over 60 people. I think there was around 68, something like that, people overall in various East Coast lobbies. And there were 26 in the Pacific Coast, the West Coast lobbies. And that was it. And, I mean, like, because you have to think too, like, it's entirely possible that there are full lobbies right now here. Okay, never mind. There's no full lobbies. That I'm completely wrong. There aren't full lobbies. Ignore me. But it's still a possibility. And then I popped into O'Neill. Two people. Two lobbies. No, I'm sorry. There were two people in one lobby. And then there was one person who had one of those Twitch stream lobbies open, which is just, you know, obviously the person's just sitting there streaming. They're probably not even at their console playing themselves. They just are streaming something all day long, but they're streaming literally nothing. How does that help you? You're not going to get viewership. What the fuck? So anyway, like I said, it's the same reason why I want to get back into Street Fighter is because no matter what, even if you want to play on PS3, which is the worst fucking console in the world for fighting games because of how it inherently works, you can still find matches on PS3 Street Fighter. PC Street Fighter's popping, Xbox Street Fighter's popping, I assume PS4 Street Fighter's probably popping now that they patched it and it made it less terrible. I don't know whether or not it's still terrible, I would assume it is due to, like, the enormous amount of problems it had. It's just, you know, they fixed some of them and eventually, maybe, hopefully, it might end up being playable. But we'll see. Oops, I didn't mean to do that. Go away! But yeah, it's just, you want to be able to put in a game and play it. You don't want to sit around for half an hour just to find one match. It's silly. And so that's why, you know, that it's the biggest flaw of the anime community is that they want to see people playing all of these various games. Oh, why is nobody streaming Persona 4 Arena anymore? Why isn't anybody streaming O'Neill anymore? Because you all fucking dropped it. You want people to be playing it, but you don't want to play it yourself. That's why. Fuck. God.